13, Ephesians 1.
By Ephesians chapter
13 to 14, we won't waste time. He says, in him, you also who have heard the word of truth, the glad tidings of your salvation, and have believed and adhered to and rely on him, were stamped with the seal of the long promised Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That is the guarantee of our inheritance, if you can see that, in anticipation of its full redemption.
Amen.
And our acquiring possession of it to the praise of his glory. Let's pray.
Amen.
Father, thank you for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I won't waste time. I want you to understand that one time I was speaking about the Holy Spirit. Today, I want us to talk about the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Because if you read there, you can see the word of God speaking plainly that we who have believed the word. That word, we believe we took it by faith. It never gone out of us. It was sealed by the Holy Spirit. In other words, that word is still in us even now. To show that we have the Holy Spirit, we have the word. And our sign of the word is the stamp of the Holy Spirit. You know, I was learning not long that without Holy Spirit, we will never go to heaven. Because if you read verse 14, it says, Holy Spirit is the guarantee of our inheritance. In other words, there is something that God has created us to have in life. The moment you have got Holy Spirit, you are guaranteed to have it. I don't know if you are hearing that. The long promised Holy Spirit was promised with a reason that what God has spoken in his word must come to pass in our lives. And the word of God must enter us and must not come out of us. You know, I'm learning this that now, as a child of God, you must check when you are studying the word of God, how far are you studying? And how far are you forgetting the word? Because we have got the Holy Spirit, that seal, when the word of God enters. Remember the Bible says, we receive the word by faith. It enters us, in other words, it enters our hearts. But it's only the Holy Spirit that seal in our hearts. So that word must not come out. It will be easy for us to pray if we have the seal, that seal the word of God, so that when we pray the word of God, we pray from the word of God that has been sealed in us. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you read 1 John chapter 4 verse 13, you find that the impartation of the Holy Spirit makes us to understand that we are in him and he is in us. The moment we receive Holy Spirit makes us one with him. Listen, me and Jesus might be looking different, but the Holy Spirit will look alike. I don't know if you're hearing me. So Holy Spirit is there to bring out our resemblance. But if we read the scripture, we have learned, which I want to take you there, how to receive the Holy Spirit, number one. If we read Acts 19, from verse 2 to 6, we found Paul going to Ephesus. When he reached there, he asked the people that he found, there were 12. In Acts there, 19, from verse 2, he asked them, and said, did you receive Holy Spirit? And the Bible says, it shows that they didn't have even an understanding of the Holy Spirit. So he brought a question to them and said, what kind of baptism did you receive? And they say, the baptism of John. He began to say, of John was to teach you to repent. But you must be baptized in the name of Jesus. That's where you'll be able to receive Holy Spirit. Here, Paul went to the people who were confessing to know Jesus and God. And he found that it was impossible for them to define Holy Spirit. And he found that the problem was their baptism was in flesh. The baptism was in men. It was not in spirit, in Jesus Christ. And he said, if you can be baptized in the name of Jesus, you'll be able to receive Holy Spirit. Listen to this. It is not only that criteria, but if you read Acts 11, and you start from 15, we found Peter saying they received Holy Spirit before they were baptized. I don't know if you're hearing that. In other words, God looks at your heart to make you to receive Holy Spirit. Because these ones of Peter, the Bible says, when Peter was still speaking, Holy Spirit fell on them. But to the one of Paul, Bible, he found that already their baptism was of men. And he began to say, no, this baptism has suffocated you. You need to start again. You need to change. And he start with them afresh. I want to tell you this. The first thing that I can tell you, when you find that you're not getting Holy Spirit, can you start afresh again? Don't start on top of something. Crush your past. Crush your history of the church you were in, the position you were having, and start a Christian life again. If you can do that, you will be able to find the word that will take you to the place where you will receive Holy Spirit. I don't know if you're hearing me. The problem we are having is our experiences. It's our abilities, our mental ascent, that derive some things that we think we know. We are developing things and we think it's the Holy Spirit. God wants us to go back for a while and start afresh. Tell a neighbor, start afresh. Leave Christianity like you have started again. Christians that will be filled and filled are those who cannot use experience. They say, no, I want to be filled more. I want to be filled again. They start from fresh. Many of you are affected because of the experiences you've experienced in churches. You must get out of churches and get unto Jesus Christ. I don't know if you're hearing me. You must get out from Pastor Humo, Pastor John the Baptist, and you get unto Jesus. The moment you get unto Jesus, the Holy Spirit from above will come upon you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the second one I'm talking about of Peter is of the people that God has prepared. Listen to this. When God wants to bring Holy Spirit, there are some people that must strive to go there.
Is
the one of John. is the one of experience. They must fight. They must crush. It's people like Nicodemus. But there are people that they just love God, but they've got no way. And they don't even understand, but they're just pushing. And say, I'm serving God, I'm here, and I don't mind, I'm doing like Cornelius. And these are the people that God prepared. And such people, sometimes they don't need baptism because they don't even know what is baptism. When Peter was still speaking, Holy Spirit fell on them. They began to speak in tongues. And later, they were baptized. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's what I say, my friend. There are some people like you. You might be the one that God has prepared you today, so that you come here and receive Holy Spirit. Can I tell you this? Once you receive Holy Spirit, you don't need somebody to prophesy you. Holy Spirit can talk. Holy Spirit can whisper. Holy Spirit can give you direction. You don't need anybody. The reason why you are confused is because you have not yet received the Holy Spirit. Listen to this. In Acts 1 verse
8,
it was so important for Jesus to tell the disciples to wait. He said, go and wait. Go and wait. Can we wait? Then we create, we have received. Can we wait for him to come? Then we create that we have it. Because we can end up acting as if we are there whereas we are not. Because in Acts 8:17, we found Philip. Philip, when he was in Samaria, when everybody received Jesus, he saw that he cannot do what Peter can do. And he called Peter and said, they have received Jesus. But I don't know what I can do now. I'm an evangelist. I end here. Can you come and check there? And among them, there was a Simon who was a witch. And this Simon, he was also converted, but Philip was not having a spirit of discerning. When Peter reached there, in verse 17, he says, he lay hands on the few in all of them there, and they receive Holy Spirit. I want to lay hands on you. I want to lay hands on you to receive Holy Spirit. That's why I said today, I need Holy Spirit. Because I want to know why I'm facing this. When Holy Spirit is there, you will know why you are facing what you are facing. When Holy Spirit is there, you will see the future. You will understand that where you are going, it's not far from what you were thinking. When you read Isaiah 63:10, the Bible says when you grieve Holy Spirit, you can be punished. Because even the Israelites in Isaiah 63:10, they rebel and grieve Holy Spirit, and God turned against them. They become his enemy and he fought them. In Psalm 51:10, David was saying, Lord, cast me not away from your presence and take me, your Holy Spirit from me. Take not your Holy Spirit from me. I want to speak about these two groups. The first group is the group that didn't have Holy Spirit. They grieve. They had Holy Spirit. And they grieve Holy Spirit. Are you hearing that? And now, the Bible says they become enemy of God. Listen to this. When you have got Holy Spirit, you are standing like this. And Holy Spirit is in front of you. And God is also in front of you. Are you hearing me? Before enemy touches you, must touch God first. When you have got Holy Spirit, can I get three people here? Can I get three people? Come, only three, only. Yes, two is fine. One is fine, fine. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to show you. Can you just face there? This one face there the same way. And come, my brother. You are represented here. By the prophet here. Here is Holy Spirit. And God is in front of you. Are you hearing me? So now, this Holy Spirit doesn't want to go away from you. But if you grieve Holy Spirit, we grieve Holy Spirit, God will turn now. Can you see that? And the Holy Spirit will move. And God will fight you. You hear what I said? The Holy Spirit is there. It's your connection with God. Remember the first one was Jesus. And when Jesus went away, he said, I won't leave you orphan. So when Holy Spirit is not there, you are orphan. No one can back you up. No one can block you. No one can fight for you. No one can block for you. I wanted to say that. So now when this God is facing there, and Holy Spirit is here, God will speak with the Holy Spirit to affect your heart, so that your heart will tell you when God say, let's move, even the Holy Spirit will take you to move. Can you see that? So now when God say, no, let's stop here, even the Holy Spirit will tell you, we are stopping here, you stop. So when you grieve Holy Spirit, you remove the Holy Spirit to come behind you, and you are becoming like God. So God is a jealousy God. So God doesn't want any other God behind him. He will turn back and destroy you. Many of you are grieving Holy Spirit. And whatever you are facing, God is talking. Are you hearing me? You need to be led by God. When you're led by God, Holy Spirit is always there. Whatever you are facing, you will overcome. Because Holy Spirit is there. I don't know, just go and see that. The Bible says he's the comforter. Are you hearing that? Friend, don't grieve Holy Spirit. So David was saying the same thing. He was saying, please, don't cast me out. Out of your presence. Because when David is here, there's the presence of God there. So if now the presence of God comes away from him, automatically God will turn and destroy him. And he said, don't take Holy Spirit from me. Because this Holy Spirit is there to comfort me, is there to lead me, is there to direct me, is there to speak with me. I don't know if you are hearing me. I want God to help you. From today, you are going to stay in his presence. And you will never have a leg. That's what I say, my friend. I want to stay in his presence. I'm seeing someone here that God is directing. This week, because of the Holy Spirit, you are going to a place where your family has never entered. You are going to be directed in your career. You will be led to a right place because of the Holy Spirit. That's what I say, my friend. I'm not a failure. I have the Holy Spirit. If you read 1 Corinthians 2:12, the Bible says we have not received the spirit of the world.
Amen.
In 1 Corinthians 2:12.
2:12.
It says, but of God to know what we have been given freely. When we have the spirit of the living God, we know what is coming. I can tell you what is coming.
You are
about to testify something that I was speaking in the beginning. I
call
it new. It's coming. New things are coming. Listen, when you've got Holy Spirit, He will direct us and show us that you are not in the dark. You can still see. The spirit of the world blindfold you, but the spirit of the Lord open your eyes to see where you're going. Confusion is not our portion. Dilemmas is not our talking. Stagnation is not our portion. Because we know where we are going. We know where we come from. And we can still see that where there is a door, God can open a door. Why? God can open it. Because we can see the door being open. No other people cannot see it. You are surrounded by people who are blind. They are always telling you, you won't make it. Why? Because they cannot see what you are seeing. When you have got the Holy Spirit, you can see a door open when it's locked. We have got Christians who are here that God is raising from now, and God wants to use them in a very amazing way. You need Holy Spirit to tell you. When He feel you are different. You can be creative in that office. You can be a leader in that stagnation. You can build a nation in that village. You can be number one because of the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit filled Peter, the Bible says He stood up. The man that was afraid, he stood up and began to say, hey, we know what has happened. That Jesus you crucified is the same Messiah we have been waiting. He was so strong that same day 3,000 were saved. I want you to stand up in your life so that when you speak by the Holy Spirit, people around you will change. We need Christians that understand that the Holy Spirit can bring the ability of the living God. Gone with your abilities. Gone with your certificate. Be gone with your certificate. Be gone with what you have achieved. There comes what God can bring to you. I want to prophesy you. Through the Holy Spirit, you are about to achieve something that in your family will see you as a leader. Your amen is very weak.
Amen.
Shake somebody and say, hey, my friend, I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. Say, I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. I'm filled with the Holy Spirit. Listen to this. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, your weakness becomes strength. Your abilities is changed. You become like God. When you speak something, it happens. Because it's no longer you now. It's the Holy Spirit in you talking. I don't know if you are hearing me. Let me prophesy you. This week, through the creativity of the Holy Spirit, there will be direction that will take you to your destiny. I see a wedding because of the Holy Spirit. I see you as a leader because of the Holy Spirit. I'm seeing you be healed because of the Holy Spirit. I'm seeing you living a life that will shock everybody because of the Holy Spirit. The Bible says when the Holy Spirit came in the day of
Pentecost,
the people were Galileans. Galileans were people who were not educated. When you stay in Galilee, you are staying around a river called Sea of Galilee. Your meat is fishes only. Your trade is fishing. And you just have to speak
and
a Galilean
language.
But when Holy Spirit came, the people around this say, we know these people. Somebody who didn't go to school began to speak English in a real accent of English. You people, you are undermining Holy Spirit. We need Christians.
Re tlhoka bapholoswa.
Who can be a CEO?
Ba ba ka bang di CEO.
Without certificate.
Ba sna le ka di pampiri tsa gona ka mo yo mogetswa.
I don't know if you are hearing.
Na ke tsebore le ntwana.
Look here, people, they don't even know English.
Ba tswa ba tsebe le segoa.
Peter was speaking
Petro ina.
A painful language by then in Israel was called Palestine. And Peter was speaking this kind of funny language that when you speak, and by that time, he began to speak a Roman language. Rome was a city. Everybody who goes to city goes with certificate. But Peter stood up and they said, what is happening? He said, no, we are not crazy. We are not drunk. We are filled with the Holy Spirit. We need Christians who can be filled with the Holy Ghost. People will say, hey, maybe you're a witch or something. Because you're going to do what nobody has ever done. I can't hear you. I need somebody born in poverty that God can raise through the Holy Spirit and make him a multi-billionaire. You are here through the Holy Spirit. Say, I'm becoming something. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We know what we can become. We didn't receive the spirit of the world. I don't have the spirit of the world. The spirit of the world. If you want to see it, go to a freeway. Are you hearing me? You want to see the spirit of the world? It's competition. This one will be, say, driving the car with high speed, like you will fall. And he's challenging you. But you know, there are some people who are there in freeway like that. Who knows what they are driving? They just enjoy what they are driving. They press, they hear the sound of the bell. And there's another one who just says, and the engine is dying. But there's another one who's driving the big engine with two doors, accelerating nicely, and hear the sound.
It's
the one with the Holy Spirit. When they are busy competing, you just press accelerator nicely and go by your own pace. Any step you take is calculated, because it takes you to your destiny of what God has predestined you. And you will never fail. I say you will never fail. I'm hearing Holy Spirit. When he filled me, I saw something. Can I tell you what I saw? The first time he filled me, I was in Vlaaglagte. So I was coming from prayer. And I went to sleep. Same time, in my sleep, I began to see in tongues. I've never done that. By then, I was singing in tongues. I was singing something like, robo, riprosika, proshike,
terobo.
And when I was busy singing, I was asking, what is it that I'm
saying?
My mind was questioning. But I could not stop what has happened in my mouth. There comes a light in the room. So I wake up, I wanted to see where the light came from. I saw someone standing in the room. And I look at the person, I could not see clear. Because his face was like a sun. And the light was more than that. So I began to speak there. When I want to speak with him, because I've never spoken in tongues, I wanted to ask, who are you? And
he said,
Kurababo, Sikato. And I hear the person say, hey, I'm Jesus. I've chosen you.
I said, cook her up or sotera. I could hear what he's saying. But what I was speaking, I didn't understand it. Because when I want to speak, when I want to ask, I speak something. But I could hear. And I cook a bruko satarabe. And that person say, hey, now you are anointed. It's what you have been searching for a long time. From that day, when I wake up, my younger brother entered. He began to push some coaches who were there. And I know that there is something in him. Because there was somebody here and who can enter in me and affect some people negatively. Sometimes when you are being hated, you don't know why they are hating you. It's because of someone in you. But the Bible, the one who's in you is greater than the one into the world. So don't look at what they are doing. Carry on with carry on speaking in tongues, because you are edifying yourself. When you are carrying on speaking in tongues, you are overpowering, you are extending your territories, you are building your house, you are driving your car. Listen, by then I had nothing, but I had joy unspeakable in me, and that makes me to rejoice. I'm here to tell you now, as you are here, you might not be having anything, but there is someone called Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He's coming to you to fill you. I said, be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the anointing. Is what you've been looking for. Is what you've been crying for. You have been waiting for today. It's the day of the Pentecost. This is the day you have been waiting for the anointing. I said, be filled with the glory of the living God. Be filled with the fire from above. I said, be filled with the anointing from above. Don't say I'm full. Say I want to be filled. Say I want to be filled. I see the grace of God upon your life. And I see the anointing falling upon your life. I see the anointing you have been waiting for. I say be filled. Be filled. Be filled. Be filled. Rakatata. From today, nobody will be able to direct you. You are a leader of yourself. You are a leader of many. From today, the Holy Ghost is coming here. Is coming. 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 Be filled. Lift up your hands and receive. Say, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Fill me now.
Fill me now.
Just keep quiet and lift your hands. It's beginning now. It's the day of Pentecost. This is the day of Pentecost. If we can pray in the Spirit, begin now. Begin now. You have been waiting for today. You didn't know that you'll be filled today. You are standing here, pastors. Pray the same thing in your heart. Because the angels who are here to monitor us.
Amen.
To look on us. Father, fill us. Fill us. Fill us.
Fill us. Give us utterances. Make us to speak in tongues. Make us to speak in tongues. Oh, Jesus. Lift up your hands and receive. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Be filled. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Lift up your hands. Something will happen to you. Something is happening. Something is happening to you. Holy Spirit. Watch, 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 watch. Oh. Jesus. 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 Be filled. Be filled. Rapa ba 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 ba. Rike peresata rapa ba ba ba. Era ta 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 ta. Era ka ta ta. Oh Jesus. Lift up your hands. Pastors there. You pastor, look here. All of you pastors there. Be filled. Ushers, go to pastors there. Not all of you, not all of you. Not all of you. Pastors, be filled. Be filled, they are falling. They are falling down there. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Hey, be filled, be filled. With the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Holy Ghost. Be filled, Pastor, be filled. I can hear your prayer. Fill me, Lord. Fill me now. Fill me, Lord. Fill me now. Oh, Father God. Fill us. There is a second group now. Ushers, be careful. There are those who are called here. There are those who are called now. Be filled. Those who are called. Be filled. Lead us to be filled. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Be filled now. Be filled right now. Rabba, ba, 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 ba. Even worshippers, Mama. Mama. Even your worshippers. These ladies, all of them, including your daughter. God is anointing them now. Be filled. Be filled. Be filled. Even you are searching for something. Receive. Receive. Also, those who are searching for something who are here, receive. Receive. I want you to hear. Can you bring a mic to this man here? Can I get two mics also? Another one. Listen. Be filled. You can hear. Can we pray to that lady there? Okay, Pastor. Come here, Pastor. Let's bring it to that lady there. Then you have passed the lady. What is very plain? In Jesus. Okay. Bring it to that brother. The one who's down. The one who's there. In Jesus' name. Amen. Listen. To you who are standing there. Don't ever think nothing has happened to you. Remember, I tried to tell you there are ways here of getting Holy Spirit. With your mouth, can you begin to thank God for Holy Spirit? Begin to thank God. Begin to thank God for the Holy Spirit. Begin to thank God. In Jesus' mighty name. There are some people here who are barren. Who are barren, who want children. And those who want children from 5 years up. And who are married. And who marry. It might be a husband or a wife. Or a wife alone or a husband alone. Come and stand there. Come and stand there. Can you just rush now? Because the one who reached there first will get twins. Stop there. Stop. Can you see them? Watch them there. Watch them there. Watch. Watch what is happening to them. Watch. Watch them there. Watch. What is it? They are falling down there. God is touching them there. Can you get your child? Receive your child. God says it's not too late. Watch. Watch. What is happening? It's not too late. Receive. Receive your baby. Receive your baby. Receive. 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 Take your child. Take your child. Any demon that is blocking your womb, any demon that is affecting you, my brother, is leaving you right now. Fibroid must come out from you. Fibroid, a cyst must come out. Come on. Watch there. They are falling down there. Congratulations. You people, you are free. You are free.
Amen.
You'll give us... You'll give us a testimony. Go back, go back. Clap hands for everyone. They are all free.